What's up, guys? It's your boy Bertrand. Today, I just got out of the park. It's winter. It's cold. That's why I got my jacket on. But that does not stop us from training. So we're going to head right off to the bars. I'm going to show you guys a few varieties of exercises that you could do with your own body weight, which is fun, very easy, but highly effective. Without that saying, let's go. Come with me. Okay, guys, today I'll be showing you guys a few of my top calisthenic workout routines I like doing, primarily to focus on every single muscle group. So we're gonna start with the first one, which is basically your pull-up. You know, pull-up, the great thing about pull-up is you have to learn how to contract your back muscle. What people usually do wrong is they ended up using their bicep to pull. No, I always say mind-muscle connection, right? If you access the right muscle in your body, you definitely feel that contraction while you're pulling yourself up. So I will show you guys the right way to do it, the different varieties. You could go brighter if you want to get brighter shoulder. But if you want to really get nice and good back, you keep it as tight as possible. So while performing the exercise, it's very important. You got to control the muscle group. Breathing is essential. Contract your leg, your core, and your back muscle while actually pulling yourself up. That way, you take your time, okay? You pretty much do not want to rush your movement. The more you use your body to pull, the more effective it can become, okay? So what you could do is, you could do, if you're really starting, you don't really have the strength to do more repetition, do about 5 reps, okay? Stop, take a break, and then from there you continue. For beginners, do not worry. I have a beginner workout video coming up in the future, which I'll show you guys how to build up from scratch to be able to get in the position that you're obviously pulling your own body weight. So, like I said, pull up, a very essential exercise. You target your lats, your back, lower back, trapeze, and your tricep muscle. So, always try to do 8, 10, or 12 reps if you're an advanced, and then try to get about 30 second break in between each set with 3 cycles. So we're gonna move to the next exercise. It's going to be your chest. So next exercise that we're going to do, we wanna focus on our chest, you know? The chest muscle, if you wanna get it, it's very important for you to train it if you really wanna get a nice posture and a nice physique. And doing push-up does not only train your chest, it train your back and your tricep muscle as well. For you to have more volume, I prefer going with a diamond push-up, okay? It is very effective, or you could still go with shoulder width level. You don't wanna go as wide as possible, you get a wider chest, but you don't really have that volume. So we will start with a diamond, okay? I'm gonna do 5 diamonds, and then from there, I transit into a normal push-ups. Breathing is essential to us as well. So while performing the diamond exercise, hands nice and straight, your core, your legs nice and contracted. And what happens is when you're going down, you really want to bring in your tricep really close to your body. It's very important while performing each exercise, control the movement. That way, the muscle is more effective. Okay, now that we've done 5, I'm going shoulder leg width, still keeping my tricep muscle really close to my body and controlling this movement. Perfect. So it's very important, like I said, control my muscle connection. You want to be able to feel the movement. If you rush the exercise, yes, you're going to get a good pump, but obviously the muscle is not as effective as it is. But by controlling every movement that you make, you definitely get the maximum effect out of it. So without that saying, 3 cycles again, okay? Try to do 12 to 15 reps, and do not forget to break in between, so for the muscles to recover. Next exercise, you guys already know, dips are one of the best exercises, not only to build up your tricep muscle, but obviously have a nice volume on your chest. So we're gonna get ahead of to that and get that workout in. So guys, we finally just arrived. We're going to do our dips now. Pretty much the same, I always say, performing dips, it's all about control. You know, I see a lot of people use their legs to be able to kick. you don't really want to get that. While you're into your dip position, you want to contract your glute muscle and your core muscle. The body is nice and static. Hands always stay really close to the body. You dip all the way down and explore up. You can see then you really get really nice on your chest, and then you get that tricep muscle working too as well. So we're gonna do 12 reps, really nice and simple. A lot of control, a lot of contraction, and obviously focusing on that breathing. So your grip has to be very important. Nice and twist, body in the same position. Down and up. So if you wanna get more chest, you can lean a little bit more forward. Cool. Nice and simple. Ooh, you can feel the pump already. You can feel it hitting your lats too as well. And you got a proper tricep muscle. I always say, every time you're training, try and focus specifically on that muscle group that you're training. So you don't want to do dips and then you feel more on your like your back or your core when you're really not focusing a lot on your tricep muscle. That's why it's always mind-muscle connection. Always control the muscle group that you're training, that way you see maximum results. So guys, now we're gonna focus on the most important muscle group of the body, which is basically your legs. Remember, I always say the legs are the bigger muscle group of your body. If you wanna really get a nice structure and stability, make sure you train your legs so you could actually increase your hormones and your testosterone level. So what we're going to do is, we're going to go into a normal squat, and then from there, we're gonna improvise straight from the knees and then a little explosion. So we could obviously hit those squats and tie muscle properly. So usually with squats, it's very important when you stand in your standing position, make sure your legs are pointing out. You drop all the way down into a 90 degree angle, okay? And explosion. So down, you could do 20 reps. That's what I usually go for. That way I could feel a lot of the muscle, you know, working and getting a lot of blood circulation into your legs. And it's very important, do not rush it. Try to control the movement as much as possible. So for people who are beginners, I highly recommend do this position as much as possible. That is obviously gonna help you to build your legs. So what we're going to do is we're going to alternate a little bit just to make sure we have a little bit more explosion coming into it. So we're going to drop into the knee position and then explore up. This is more advanced, which I like doing. So what you're doing is, once you drop on your knees, you use your hips to be able to kick yourself up. That way you get more explosion out of the exercise. It is very technical, so it takes a lot out of you. Breathing too is important while performing the exercise, and that's basically it. So while doing this exercise, try and do the most that you can, okay? Like I said, it's very difficult. Breathing, focus on your technique, focus on your form, and you definitely get it good. So take 15 to 20 reps, 3 cycles. Or what you could do is, if you don't want to do reps, you do 45 seconds in each exercise, and then you take a break. Yo guys, so now that we're done with our legs, we're going to the final exercise for the day, which is basically your ab workout for you to be able to get that nice strong core. Obviously work on your V, get the lats actually engaged, and obviously strengthen up your lower back, as you have to understand, this is your center of gravity. It's always important for you to train abs. So I got some new ab workout routine coming up soon. You guys should definitely stay tuned and check that out. But for now, we're gonna finish our workout routine with some mountain climbers, okay? While performing the mountain climbers, it's very important that you keep your hips nice and low and actually bring your knees all the way close to your elbows and just focus on your breathing. Try to breathe with every repetition. Make sure you contract your glutes and keep your core nice and tight. That way you get that engagement. So let's go. Perfect. Like I said, breathing is essential, okay? You have to learn how to master your breathing. The more you breathe, the more effective it can become. The more you hold your breath, obviously you don't feed your muscle with enough oxygen, you become a bit fatigued. So usually I always say, try to do about 45 seconds or 60 seconds, and then take about 15 to 30 second break in between each set, and do about 4 cycles. So that's all I have to show you guys. Do not forget to leave a comment, subscribe. If you have any question of what you want to see next, leave a comment. I'm definitely going to answer to you. So till next time, share this video with your friends, and I'll see you guys. I'm out. Shoulders on ice for y'all. Frozen. 86 all the hate. I won't get involved today. Got lost in the ballin' age. I'm flipping the balls. I'm flipping the flipping.